21-23. Thank you. Have a nice day.
By day, Weston is but a simple checkout clerk.
17-13. Thank you, ma'am.
But things are not always what they seem, for by night, Weston is a broken and beaten young man who works as a simple checkout clerk by day.
1276, ma'am. 1714. 2124. You're welcome. Have a nice day. This is it. This is my big chance. If I don't act right now, then I'll never be a real superhero. If I don't...
Get away from her, you dastardly urban thugs.
What do you want? We're just having a little fun.
And Robin. We're Robin, too.
Help me! Ugh.
The snot out of those hoodlums.
Don't mention it, kid.
No, really, that was...
I'm sure you'd have done the same thing if you hadn't been hiding. Well, I must be off.
Wait, no, you don't understand. All my life, I've been waiting to find a real superhero. Something familiar about that guy. Well, I don't have to be at work for 6 more hours.
And so young Weston pursues the strangely familiar man. He chases him high and low. He chases him here and there. He chases him everywhere. He chases him round and about. He chases him inside out. He chases him hither. He chases him yon. He follows him closely across the lawn. After this incredible chase of daring do, young Weston discovers the man's adventurous secret.
Holy contrived, conspicuous clue! But it could be a coincidence. Holy plot helper! I think I might be onto something. Then he must be... must be... you! I knew I recognized you!
How did you get into my impossibly secret lair? The pelican's nest should be impregnable.
I climbed. You left the trap door open.
Ah! You dastardly doggone delinquent.
No, you don't understand. See, I knew I recognized you. You're the Pelican Man, in disguise as your secret identity, Ross T. Preston.
How could you possibly know that? Who do you work for? Captain Herring? The Special Hell Twins? Professor Seuss? Batman? Superman?
No. Super Center.
How do you know my secret identity?
It was in the comic book.
My secret identity was published in a comic book?
Yeah. In, like, every edition.
What?
Mild-mannered and bathrobe-wearing Ross T. Preston by day, the adventurous gentleman, Pelican Man, by night.
This was in every issue?
Yeah.
Where did you get this adventurous serial?
Comic book?
It's over 100 years old.
My great-grandfather gave it to me.
I see. Get out of here, kid.
No, wait. But you're the Pelican Man. The greatest superhero ever lived.
I know. Look, I said get out of here. Did you say greatest?
Yeah.
Do you mean like Batman or Superman?
Well, they're more famous and have bigger budgets and better enemies, but you're like the Coca-Cola classic of superheroes.
What's Batman then?
Coke Zero? My grandfather told me all about you. You're the greatest, and I'm your biggest fan. Well, look, I know what you need, what you've always needed. You need a sidekick. Well, I know it may not look like much, but you know, when the chips are down, I can be pretty fearsome, like a weasel.
Look, I'm I'm retired.
Retired? Why? You live forever. It says so right here on page 12.
Yes, I know. My one
Pelican Man's one and only superpower was not invulnerability, super strength, speed, or intellect. No. Pelican Man's power, just like that of the majestic pelican, was that of immortality. No matter what horrific death befell the mighty pelican, he would rise again to fight crime and the enemies of truth and justice.
That is so cool.
Yeah, sounds cool. But what you don't realize is that every time I die...
The only flaw in this incredible power is that with every death, Pelican Man loses all of his memories, except for a detailed memory of each death.
Are you doing that?
No, I thought it was you. Weird.
Yeah. Anyway, look, once you've been blown up, lit on fire... Drowned, tortured, put on the rack, kicked in the face to death, anesthetized to death, crushed by a bookshelf, blown up by tanks, and married. Well, the whole crime-fighting thing loses its appeal. I'm 60 now, and if I die now, I have to start all over again.
But what about the agents of evil and enemies to harmony?
But they have guns.
Come on, but you're the pelican!
Just then, the pelican mail alert sounds. What could this mean for our intrepid adventurers?
No, you take that back. I am not adventurous, and I sure as hell am not intrepid. This is how it all starts.
Holy fabulous floral fragrance. Flowers and a note. I wonder what this could mean.
Don't start talking like that. The moment you do, that voice comes back.
What could this mysterious note be? Truly, our heroes must have stumbled upon a mystery fantastic.
No, not heroes. No more heroes, no more barracudas, no more...
The note reads, "You have thoughts in your head, you have riddles in your eyes. Just don't go back to bed, or you'll fall for my lies." Sounds like a mystery to me, Pelican Man.
Don't call me that. I know it does not sound like a mystery at all.
Oh, come on. You must be at least a little bit tempted.
Adventurer Ross struggles with his one and only weakness, a crippling addiction to mystery.
Oh, come on. It's not dangerous just to solve this teeny, tiny puzzle, right?
Okay. Let's see what you're made of, kid. What's the flower wrapped in?
Why, cellophane.
Which means?
Well, of course. Cellophane was originally created in 1912.
Which is the same year that...
The Girl Scouts of America were founded. On the 12th of March. It's so obvious.
And March starts with the same letter as Maine.
Of course. 1212 Main Street.
Which could only mean...
Great crusading catfish! Whoever this is planning to steal the Main Street Bank with a giant net of cellophane.
Not bad, kid. What'd you say your name was, Weston?
To the Pelican Mobile!
Whoa, no. This is obviously the work of Professor Seuss.
So?
He's my arch nemesis.
And?
He has minions.
And?
They have guns. Lots of guns. Maybe even tanks. I remember one time they had these barracudas that were just...
But you're...
Pelican Man!
What he said.
No, I'm not going to do it. I'm old, I'm comfortable, and I'm terrified of young people.
What's the matter with you? It's time to save the day. What if there are people in that bank?
I'm sure it'll work itself out.
I don't believe this. My grandfather said you were the greatest superhero who ever lived.
Adventurous gentleman.
Whatever. He said you were the greatest. All the other kids used to laugh at me when I wore my pelican suit to school. They said I had a learning disability.
With that, disgusted by what was once his greatest hero, Weston runs out of the room, never to return.
So, you gonna,
Yeah.
So, Weston decides to take things into his own hands.
I can't believe I idolized that D-bag. A superhero my butt. He's just a crotchety old man. You know, it's time for me to be a real superhero. For I am...
At that moment at the Main Street Bank, the ever-silent Professor Seuss and his dastardly minions prepare for their evil plot.
Yes, Professor. The bomb's all set. Cellophane's ready. Don't you fret.
And I did my job, too. You bet?
Soon, the bell will be rung. The trap will be sprung.
Oh, and evil will be done.
That was a slant rhyme, you dolt. Look! Over there! Should we bolt?
Where are they? I don't see anyone! No! You'll never get away with this, Professor Seuss!
Poor, simple checkout clerk Weston Taggart is now the prisoner of the terrifying Professor Seuss. With Batman and Aquaman on vacation, and the Pelican Man a washed-up retiree, how will he escape? Tune in next time to the adventures of Pelican Man and Squirrelboy.